Vertical farming isn't new, but this crop might give it a new oomph. Pure Agrobusiness is a company that sells equipment to grow legal cannabis, a market worth $6 billion in 2016 and expected to reach $50 billion by 2026, according to Cowen and Company. Bloomberg recently spoke with its CEO and founder, Rick Bird, who said that because cannabis has higher profit margins than food and pot is mostly grown inside, he hopes the innovations perfected by Pure Agro could one day revolutionize food production. His vision goes well beyond growing pot. He says it's the perfect catalyst to bring in what I really think needs to change in farming. You can't have the average produce truck going 1,500 miles to get to your plate. And there's no way, obviously, to farm the amount of acres we would need to feed New York City unless we go vertical. Bird imagines a 100-story glass skyscraper filled with floors of stack beds of fruits, vegetables, and grains. The same technology that currently enables vertical indoor farms to raise primo weed can one day produce perfect tomatoes or succulent lettuce, according to the report in Bloomberg. Paper or mesh holds up the plants, substituting for soil. Powerful lights do the work now done by the sun, but better. Data calibrates the exact light spectrum and nutrients for the plants to thrive, and machines drip just enough water. Harvests are frequent, 4 or 5 a year, compared with just 1 outdoors. Making urban farms vertical instead of horizontal could cut agriculture's reliance on fossil fuels and diminish risks from pests, pesticides, and an increasing haywire environment, Bird said. And examples for food, not pot, actually exist today. Sky Greens in Singapore began operating in 2012 to reduce reliance on food imports. Plants are grown using hydroponics, without soil, in aluminum frame. In the offices of Tokyo-based human resource company Posana Group, 20% of the space is used to grow vegetables, 10,000 square foot of growing beds and light share space with conference rooms and offices. The building produces 100 different kinds of fruits and vegetables. It's time we start looking over our shoulder and see what else is being done, sometimes even better, that we can incorporate in the food supply chain.